Today's lecture is going to cover distortion. Distortion is the misrepresentation of the size or shape of the structures being imaged. Size distortion involves magnification. Shape distortion involves elongation or foreshortening. There is an inverse relationship between distortion and detail. As distortion increases, detail decreases. The factors that affect distortion include SID and OID. They affect the size distortion or magnification. Shape distortion is affected by angulation of the beam or of the part and alignment of the primary beam to the part or image receptor. Typically, distortion is known as a degrading quality, but it can be used to the radiographer's benefit. We can angle to elongate or open foramen. We can magnify to see something larger. We can also use a tube angle in order to reduce superimposition. An example of this would be a lordotic chest x-ray. In order to reduce distortion, we want the longest SID and the shortest OID. We need to align the tube and part and image receptor perpendicular to one another. Every patient is a different size or shape, and organs in the body are approximately in the same location for every patient. The area of interest cannot always be placed directly against the upright buccal table or image receptor, so some distortion is uncontrolled. To calculate size distortion, we use the magnification factor formula, which is SID divided by SOD. This tells you how much the image will be magnified from its actual size. To calculate object size, the object size formula is image size divided by the magnification factor. This tells you the actual size of the object that's being imaged. You must first calculate the magnification factor in order to use this formula. Shape distortion is misrepresentation by unequal magnification of the actual shape of the part being imaged. Elongation makes the part appear longer and occurs when the tube or the image receptor are misaligned. Foreshortening makes the part appear shorter and occurs when the part is misaligned. For most exams, the tube and primary beam and part and image receptor should be perpendicular to one another. This is not always achievable, such as when we're doing portable exams. Some challenges we face when we're trying to minimize distortion. Structures of the body do not align in exact planes. A patient may not be able to be positioned routinely. For example, if they're kyphotic, lordotic, if there's a fracture or injury, if they have severe pain, or if they are stiff. The image receptor may not be able to be positioned routinely. In order to use angulation, there are different directions. Cephalad or cephalic would be angled toward the head. Caudad or caudal would be angled toward the feet. The degree is the amount of angulation, and this determines the amount of distortion. In summary, typically, distortion is degrading to the quality of the image, but it can be used to the radiographer's benefit.